Well, Dan, apparently this missing sailboat did not have a working GPS, did not have an emergency radio beacon, and did not have any life rafts, the things avid boaters say are safety essentials, especially when you're miles out at sea.
They have the approved life jackets, proper amount.
Tim Murison believes he has all the essential survival tools for his sailing trip to Southern California. He also has the basics, life jacket, flares, VHF radio, and much more.
This is a four-person raft. It's inspected and serviced every 3 years, and so the next service is due on April of 2015.
He believes in safety, especially when taking long sailing trips along the high seas.
This stuff has to be up to date. But that's only going to take care of you locally. You know, once you're out of reach, you know, it's more personal safety. And if you care about your life, then you know, you want to have the right stuff on.
We require that our students wear life jackets at all times.
Mark Kraft of Pacific Yachting and Sailing in Santa Cruz has been teaching boating for 30 years. He too recommends if you're taking a long trip, you've got to be prepared and take all the precautions.
People say to us that, you know, boy, it takes this long, 8 days, and that's just to do day sailing. People need to understand that they might go out on a day that's not that rough, but then, you know, 2 weeks later, they'll go out and it's really rough. So they have to know how to handle every condition.
The Coast Guard says there are requirements. Children under the age of 13 must always wear a life jacket. You want to have a VHF radio that can broadcast on channel 16 in an emergency, and a working GPS.
The more safety measures you can put in place, the safer you're going to be on the water. And that's what the Coast Guard really stresses, is boating safety. So everything you can do to make yourself safe, we want you to do.
And of course, we don't know all of the circumstances surrounding this missing boat. The Coast Guard lost communication with it late yesterday afternoon, but you can improve your odds of surviving a disaster at sea if you can prepare as much as possible. Dan and Aaron.
Good advice. All right, thank you, Phil. Coast Guard has put in calls to harbors throughout California trying to locate where the family may have set sail. So far, database searches have come up empty. They've expanded the search now to include Hawaii, Seattle area, and Canada.